Palestinian spokesperson here in other places trying to defend Hamas. These people cannot enter Gaza. I don't understand why on earth they want to try and explain and protect the acts of Hamas. We have to separate between these two issues, Palestinian Authority and the Hamas.
We have seen Israel starting a process of normalizing relations with many countries in the region. Won't this bombardment of Gaza reverse these activities that have been going on, at least the progress of it?
I'm sure it will not. Probably you've seen the statements of United Arab Emirates, other Arab countries. The whole Abraham Accord process, the 3-year-old process, and the signing of the establishing diplomatic relations with Gulf states, with Morocco. One of the motivations was that they felt that they are being again held. I would not say hostages, but they are kept, because of the Palestinian issue. They have their own interests. And if I can think about a connection between the process in the Gulf and the attack, the murderous attack of the Hamas, is maybe the recent reports by different international media about the discussions that Israel has with Saudi Arabia. We saw, of course, also Israeli ministers landing and visiting Saudi Arabia on different international forums. And more the Hamas equals Iran, understand that they will be even more isolated if a big important country like Saudi Arabia will establish diplomatic relations with Israel. So no doubt that this was also a motivation for this Hamas-ISIS style attack.
Well, in your opinion, what should the international community, at least what role should they play in order to restore normalcy in Gaza and, of course, Israel?
We are talking in Israel these days that these are the days we haven't experienced something like this from the time of the Holocaust. In what sense? That innocent children, 5, 7, 8 years old, are taken, are pulled from their houses, shot at close range. It's not an army. We did have many casualties in the Yom Kippur War 50 years back, October the 6th, 73, but this is another story. A Holocaust survivor was hijacked and is now in Gaza, a Holocaust survivor. So we are in another situation. And if the international community, and as I said, gladly the leaders of the international communities, the best friends of Israel, have realized it, that we are in another situation. And this is why they came very forcefully, very clearly condemning, supporting Israel's right of self-defense. Because these terrorist organizations have one thing that they like to do, copy-paste. They copy to their own places. I don't want to try and give now all the similarities or ideas to nobody, but we should look how the Hamas terrorists infiltrated Israel. They were not using tanks. And let's bear this in mind, learn the lesson, and forget about a balanced approach. There's no room for a balanced approach.
About the balanced approach, as I'm concluding this conversation, I would like to know your position on the two-state solution.
In 2000, Israel, then Prime Minister Barak, and his follower, successor, Prime Minister Olmert, have offered the Palestinian a deal and 95% of the land and population. 95%. we're in the Middle East. If you get a 50% deal, you're very happy. 70%, you are extremely talented. 95%, you take and run, right? 95%, this is what we offer. This is all in writing. It's not what an Israeli diplomat says or doesn't say. It's all in writings. It's all in the archives. And the Palestinian decided to reject it. When I will see a Palestinian peace movement, a Palestinian left-wing party, a Palestinian effort to come to the table and say, even if they don't believe in us, let's go back to the Camp David agreements. Why don't we hear it from the Palestinian Authority? Why don't we hear it from all the ambassadors? Why don't we hear condemnations of such terrible attacks? Two things, condemning the attack and say that's the time to go back to the Camp David agreements. When we hear this, we can talk about implementing things.
Well, I would like you to give us your parting comments, Mr. Ambassador, as we are closing off this section.
You know, for me, in the last few days, and for so many Israelis, we watch the movies, the video clips, we read the correspondence, the last words of the victims, surrounded by, I can't say animals, because here in Africa, we admire animals, and animals don't kill for the sake of killing.
Yes.
So with this non-human Hamas terrorists, and it's very difficult to go to bed and sleep. You know, I have my own son who was recruited, mobilized, the same as so many other Israelis. I hope that we will be able to annihilate the capacity, the military capacity of the Hamas fast, in the minimum price for of lives for Israelis and Palestinians the same.
Well, thank you so much, Your Excellency. That was Michael Lotem, the ambassador of Israel to Uganda.